Hello and welcome back to the Misfits Podcast, rated 5 stars on iTunes by Sneaky Cunt. He says, erect waffle. He says, well, ignore that part. That was just the subtitle is erect waffle, unrelated. He says, I beat my wife while listening to this. It helps me concentrate on where I'm going to hit her. Glad to be of service to you there, Sneaky Cunt. That sounds like a relaxing pastime, beating your wife. I'm joined today by my co-host.
Hey, Fitz, that's really fucked up. That's messed up, man. Domestic violence isn't a joke.
You think so?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was kind of funny.
What if it's two clowns beating the shit out of each other?
No.
What if it's like two like real little people? They're kind of comically small, and then like he trips her over and she's like, ah.
No.
This is Toby.
Hi.
I'm joined also by Swagger Souls off camera.
Hello.
Mason, a.k.a. Zuckles.
G'day.
Jay, a.k.a. McCreamy.
What's going on?
And big boy Matt.
Hey.
What it do?
Guys, this is going to go on YouTube. The last one did. Obviously, that was me being bald. Yeah. Still bald. Just wearing
bald
a hat,
and
guys.
Bald.
It's all good. Bald and bald.
Yep.
Jay's not bald. He's just got a skin-tone hat.
It's beige.
Yeah, don't be confused. It's only a beanie, everyone.
Yeah, he didn't get the champion logo tattooed on his face.
I have not done that.
You may also notice that we're all kitted out in Misfits merch. We've got...
Yo, gang.
Three prison inmates here.
Let's
in all
go.
Orange. And then we got the white boys.
White supremacists.
White.
Ooh, white.
We decided on the white boys as the
name. Oh, white boys.
Yeah, not the white former one. That was a different time.
Sorry.
Guys, what's been going on? I mean, it feels like the video podcast actually went up this morning. That's when I put it live. It's been somewhat well received.
Yeah.
I've been trying to avoid the comments, to avoid people expressing extreme disappointment in my lack of hair. But it's been all good.
I had a resting bitch face for the entire
podcast.
You
seem hung up on the fact that you have a resting bitch face. I didn't really notice it that much. It was more just that you were sitting back.
I just looked really angry the whole time.
Yeah, but I can relate. I have a resting bitch face. I always look angry.
Ooh, the fans don't know that, though.
Yeah.
They've seen my eyebrows. They can kind of, I guess, guess.
Nah. You can't tell from the eyebrows alone the sheer magnitude of your resting bitch face.
See, Miss Audience, I've decided my fate from the beginning where they set up the cameras with me leaning back, which means I have to lean back every podcast now, which means I always just look
like... Look, I'm up here in the frame, and you're just down here like a little hobbit.
No, because if I put my mic up, then it blocks Jay or something. I don't know. I don't know exactly what it does.
Well, whatever. You're cruising. You're chilling.
I'm extremely comfortable.
Big chilling.
Though.
I wouldn't say that you have a resting bitch face, Swagger. It's more just like, it's like a aggressive face. It's more aggressive than a bitch face.
Thank you.
It's like an angry
dad face.
That makes
me feel way better.
It's like a good thing. It's like it's good unless you're trying to like tell a kid like, hey, I hope you have a good day. In which case, it's just going to be a confusing message for them.
Not going to work.
Like if you go up to a kid and be like, hey, you want an ice cream? He's going to be like, holy fuck, like, what is this aggression coming from this
hey,
man?
Hey, kid, want
to
get in my van? I have a puppy in there.
It's like, you're not going to get away with that
no
kind
way.
Of stuff.
Yeah.
Like, your future as a pedophile
is
ruined.
I'd
by
never
your
make it.
Resting angry face. You look great when you laugh, though. It's when the eyebrows go up, and then it's like, ah, look at this welcoming, lovely man.
You know, high cheekbones, very jolly.
Yeah.
What are you looking at, Mason?
Your fucking head cunt. So bald.
It's bald, you know. It's all good. I'll take the hat off.
Oh, nice.
The problem
nice.
Is that, like,
come on, I get a glare. Going into my eyes.
The problem is that, like, I have to, if I'm going to rock it, I have to truly rock it and shave it regularly.
Oh, yeah.
Because otherwise, I get, like, the number one look and it just looks a bit weird.
Yeah, I'm starting to look like Sid from Toy Story.
You can look good with, like, the short. I think that for me, it's either, like, I grow it out or I just continue shaving it down to the fucking scalp.
Scalping yourself.
I don't know. It's been like over a week now of me being bald. Mm-hmm. I'm still enjoying the benefits.
Yeah.
Still not really sure how I feel about the way it looks, but you know, I'm gonna say it. I'm glad that I did it. I'm glad
I
gave it a try.
Yeah, that's lit, dog.
That's what
counts. You think that matters.
And to all the Twitter stans who are saying, you know, I can't believe they seem more disappointed than like
they're not even disappointed. They're fucking devastated.
They're like, no, the hair. I mean,
that's really funny. I kind of just would have assumed that the stans would be like, I support anything you do, Seth.
Some of them are like that. Some of them are definitely disappointed.
They're probably hoping to like meet up with you at an event and like snip off a little bit of your hair, put it in like their collection book of photos of you. Mm-hmm. You can't do it anymore.
It's
like
what
I did when I first met you all.
Tough shit. Okay, guys. It's, I didn't do it for the stands. I did it for me.
Yeah.
You know?
That's
what matters. Mm-hmm. Anyway, what's been going on in the last week besides that?
Mason, why don't you explain what you got up to last night?
Yeah, so I built the Taj Mahal with my brother. Finally unboxed that.
It's just clarify, out of Lego.
yeah, out of Lego. We didn't actually build the Taj Mahal, mate. No. Yeah, we spent about 7 hours on it, and it just got kicked over about 4 times by Swags.
You got to explain why it got kicked over.
Yeah, so we had a donation goal, and every time we'd reach it, Swags would come in and boot it over. For the first 2 times, we did it for $500 because, you know, we didn't want to be too much of a tired ass. And then we ended up bumping up to $1,000 because fuck that.
Big boy numbers.
That's fair. Yeah. It would have taken you 4 months to build it.
So. Yeah, well, I mean, we could have probably got it done if it hadn't been booted over. Yeah. But unfortunately...
Wait, hang on. Were you aware that he was going to come in and boot it over, or do you have no idea?
Yeah, donation goal was actually called Swag's Kick.
Okay. So. Yeah. So you knew going into this that this was going to happen.
Watching them, they were so defeated. After the first kick, they were just like... What's the point building it? He's just going to come in and kick it again.
Yeah, that's exactly what you were saying.
And God, like, I was watching it, and as soon as I saw Swagger kick it the final time, I ran downstairs and I was like, because I just saw Mason sitting on the ground, just looked so defeated, so done.
You could feel the, like, you just felt miserable.
I felt bad. Yeah. I felt bad to do it, but that was the whole premise. That was the entire premise, was that I would come down and fucking kick it. So, you know, you can't really hate me for it.
Yeah.
You know,
but make some money.
When I kicked it the last time, the goal was Swag shirtless stomp. So I had to take my shirt off.
Which, by the way, just so you know, could have got Mason banned on Twitch.
Really?
You're not allowed to be shirtless on Twitch.
I'm that hot, huh?
Can't have no nipples on
that's
Twitch.
Very odd. Yeah. That's a dumbass rule. But anyways, we did it anyways. And, you know, I come down in my onesie just tied around my waist. And I just fucking go up.
That was actually you?
That was me.
I skipped through the VOD this morning and all I saw was like very little progress being made on the Taj Mahal. And then at some point, just a shirtless guy in a helmet that was Swag. I didn't even like I didn't know who the fuck it was. I was like, someone's taken his helmet.
They actually made a lot of progress, but you just couldn't tell because a lot of the stuff was off screen. And I mean, for anyone watching at home, it was 5,000 pieces.
They were about 1,200, 1,500 pieces in by the time I finally kicked it.
They had tiny pieces too. It was like a tiny little thing.
It was very impressive.
Mm. Whoa. Yeah.
Every time I got kicked over to, we'd have to fucking search for every individual
piece.
Because, oh my God, true.
Because the first time they didn't have that much done. And I'm like, well, I have to make it an inconvenience. So I just kicked it under the bed. And they had to go under the bed and find all the pieces, and that was the whole thing.
But I said at one point you kicked something into a wall.
Yes,
I missed that bit.
I think that was the second one.
What time of the night did you start the stream?
So nine p.m.
No, it was like 11.
Are you sure?
Yeah, because we went till 6.
Yeah,
6 a.m. Right. Yeah, the time.
Wait, are you serious?
Yeah. It was till 5 or 6 a.m. Yeah,
everyone in the house was up till then as well.
Yeah, we were fucked by the end, man. Like. I think we were all fucked.
And you, like, your sleep schedule has been fixed as well. Yeah. So you were up for a long time.
Yeah. Jeez. I was really struggling by then.
Why did you decide to do it so late in the evening?
Well,
Was it like a spur of the moment decision, or did you plan this?
No, just spirit in the moment, yeah.
Just fucking, let's build the Taj Mahal, let's stream it.
Yeah.
Good
fucking
audience.
Sick.
Yeah, it was you and your brother, right? It was Kobe?
Yep, me and Kobe.
Right. Shout
you should
Kobe.
Send the stream to an editor and get them to make a video out of it.
I'm going to edit it up.
Yeah, he was
chop the fuck out of it, make some sick shit out of it.
Like Mr. Beast type shit.
Do you remember back when you still lived in Geelong, streaming, you changing the light bulb?
Oh my God. That was one of the most epic streams I've ever seen.
That should have been a video.
I think it was you and me, right? Yeah. Me and Jay were in a call watching that stream, just laughing our asses off, and I was recording the entire thing.
Literally dying.
Recording my desktop. I think I might still have the footage.
You sent it to me. I've seen it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you've seen it? Yeah. I mean, it's going to get copyrighted because you were playing like Hans Zimmer the whole time, but that is something worth revisiting.
Yeah, I think it's worth it, even getting demonetized. It's so hilarious.
It's like changing a light bulb. It's one of those things.
It
was so simple.
Still can't do it.
So great.
You made it so epic.
Well, you were freaked out by it. You thought you were going to get electrocuted and shit.
Yeah, well, fucking who knows, cunt. You know, I've been in pools with toasters at this stage. You don't fucking know what's going to happen.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, an unplugged toaster you thought was going to electrocute you.
People love weird streams like that. Like, a few weeks ago, probably a couple months ago now, I had to build some shelving units for my room, and I was like, fuck it, I'll just stream it. So I built the shelving units. It was like 5 hours or something, and people fucking loved it, and people have asked me to do more shit like that. Unfortunately, I'm like, Well, I don't need any more IKEA bills. But, yeah. I reckon I'll just fill my room.
I might just open a PO box and just get cunts to send me Lego and just fucking build it.
Like, become a Lego streamer.
I mean, we do have a PO box.
Yeah. Well, there you go, guys.
Yeah, should we plug that?
Yeah, we should plug that.
Well, do you want to open up some of the PO box right now? Just while he's getting those packages, because we do have some packages from the PO box to open, I'm just going to plug the new Patreon real quick. Because
Patreon.
We've decided to open a Patreon, obviously optional. But basically, the thing is with these videos is that they're very fucking expensive to make. There's a lot of there's a lot of resources that go into them money-wise. Even just the trip to IEM Sydney was really fucking expensive. And there's a few other projects that we've been working on that are unreleased, which just are racking up in fucking cost. So we're like, look, okay, let's launch our Patreon. Let's see like if we can crowdfund this and just make it so that you guys can fund and we can just have a set fund where it's like all of this is just going to go into making epic videos.
And that's all it will go to as well.
It's all it will go to. Yeah, like we will not personally be collecting on the Patreon. It's only to put back into what you guys are seeing. So yeah, it's up right now. It launched today. If you want to support us, you can get all kinds of perks. Exclusive early access to the Misfits podcast, uncensored and unreleased Misfits.
There's some funny shit.
There is funny shit. Uncensored and unreleased Misfits vlog content. So just lots of extras. We got so many deleted scenes that just don't make it in. All kinds of crazy shit. Discounts on merch, access to Patreon only Discord, and just general stuff like that. So
in other words, it's fucking worth.
Yeah, so. It's actually good perks.
Yeah, and we tried to make the prices really reasonable as well.
Yeah.
Because our intention wasn't to make it that we were making the most money from it. Our intention was purely to make it so that the most people will be able to get access to the most content from it. So I think the lowest tier has most of the good stuff anyway, which is cool.
Yeah, it's really just paying for, you know, extra shit if you want it. It's totally optional. Yeah. But yeah, if you really are interested in pledging, which would be very much appreciated, you can click the link in the description of the YouTube video or go to patreon.com/misfits to support us and get access to all of those juicy rewards. Swagger, how are we looking there with that mail that you've been opening
up? There's some fucking good shit in here, man. There's some interesting stuff. We got letters for everybody here.
Pass some things along. Maybe we should letters out.
Yeah, we got one for Mason. We got one for Cam. Just pass that down. We got one for Matt. Just pass it down. We got one for Jay. Just pass it down. One for Toby.
If you're listening to the audio of this on Spotify or iTunes or SoundCloud, maybe
listen to this ASMR of us opening letters.
Or go and check out the YouTube channel because these will be posted on there now. Okay, that's a little too close to the mic there, Matt. All right. I actually ripped my letter by mistake.
Oh, toxic.
Oh, it's actually ripped right in the middle as well. I'm sorry.
This is from someone that watches my streams. They asked me if I had received a pride flag.
Well, there you go.
Uh-huh. Hold up to the camera.
Okay, well, I'm going to read this one. I reckon that this doesn't have anything too depressing in it. All right, this guy says, Dear Fitz, dude, you are so cool. You're telling me. I love that you kind of are the dad of the group. Huh? You guys agree? Surely. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, 100%.
You're already balding, so.
Dude, absolutely just took me out by my kneecaps there. Plus your rocket games, apparently. Most first person. Nice one, dude. I wish you streamed, but I understand that you don't and respect that decision. Oh, thank you very much, man. Anyway, thank you for being who you are. Your support and love for the guys, no homo, keeps them together, especially in the beginning. I love that you and Toby have this long history and that you still stick together. It's the sex that keeps us together, really, isn't it?
Yeah, we don't even play games anymore.
No eye contact either. Sex. It inspires me to keep making friends, even though I lose mine very quickly. Oh, matey, come on. On a bad day, watching you and Swags gives me the strength to leave the house because I laugh enough to not cry. Oh, Sammy, mate, thank you very much for your letter. There you go, old mate Sam.
Thanks, Sam, for all the stuff.
Thanks for this. Is this all
from
Sam?
Where's the stickers? We're supposed to have stickers.
I believe this is all from Sam. Yeah, we do have stickers here.
What is
this? Yeah, stickers all, for me and Jay.
These stickers are, we got Wonder Woman, we got Captain America, Shield, we have an Autobot logo, we have Superman and Batman. This seems to be a car. I don't know. I think it's a Skyline. I don't know.
For Matt?
What is this thing?
Hmm?
What is
that? I think that's for Toby. Cars for Toby. Yeah, he gets a sticker.
It's a Subi.
Ooh, a Subi? Yeah. What is Subaru?
Yeah.
You're showing these stickers, and I don't think anyone can even see them on camera, probably. But
my stickers are better.
Is this all from Sam?
Yeah.
All right.
I believe this is all from Sam. We also have a Tamagotchi, dead as fuck.
No!
Probably has been dead for 15 years.
Sitting in the mail.
No. Not a dead Tamagotchi.
Shout out to anyone who remembers Tamagotchi. Is he still around? Is he still a thing?
And also, I had one. For some reason, a box filled with earrings.
I'm not putting those anywhere near my ears.
Just yoinked it from his mother.
Oh, I really
just
hope
steal
not.
Some jewelry.
That's a little odd.
Should we get our ears pierced live on the podcast and chuck those bad
fuck
boys
off.
In?
Fuck
off. That's a dangerous idea. And we also have some fan art here, some really awesome fan art.
Oh, awesome. Chuck that over here.
That's a gut.
Oh, okay. Good enough. Look, chuck it here. I'll hold
cool
up to the
one.
Camera.
All right.
Fuck, that's actually hella
that's
sick.
That's actually nice.
Look at that shit.
Very awesome.
That's some good shit.
Yo, that's dope.
That's actually fucking pog. Is this from Sam? All from Sam?
Well, I believe this was all from Sam. This was all from the one box.
Mate, legendary. We should put this up on the fucking fridge.
Give us a game.
That's actually some good shit.
That was awesome.
All right, what else is up in that little box
fucking
here?
Oh, fuck yeah.
This is just another box. It came with a...
That one was addressed to Toby Souls.
Yeah, so
you and I.
So for me and you...
That's some good handwriting.
I don't think we should read that. That's a long letter.
Yeah, we should have read all the letters.
It's a very long letter.
Yeah.
We'll read that off camera.
Later, but let's see what they fucking gave us.
Yeah, I bet it's a bracelet.
I bet it's a dildo. Guys, if you want to send us stuff at the P.O. Box, it's all the details are down below in the description.
Also, sponsored by G-Sups.
Let's just get it all out of the way.
Let's get our sponsors
sponsored
out.
By G-Sups. Guys, we've been sponsored by G-Sups for a while. We absolutely love them. I personally drink it almost every day, especially before recording.
So
I've had two cups
and I'm absolutely beaming.
It's keto-friendly.
It
it's organic.
Friendly.
I'm loving it.
It's not chalky like fucking G Fuel, which is trash.
Fuck G Fuel!
Come on, G Fuel. What the heck, dude? G Subs is where it's at.
Look,
damn right.
Gamer Subs.
Genuinely, though, I've had both, and I prefer Gamer Subs any day of the week. It's actually good shit.
My lots of flavors. Yeah, very much variety.
My favorite flavor is probably the blueberry acai. That's the one that I have at my house, the one that I drink all the time. It's good shit.
Mm-hmm.
What's in the box, Swag?
This one is interesting.
Looks like arts and
crafts.
Because
it is bracelets for everybody, and with letters inside. On the letters, it says, please do not read in a video.
Thanks for clarifying.
Hey, we'll just toss these, chuck the bracelets on.
Oh, hell yeah. Well, they're actual bracelets?
They are legit bracelets.
Mate, friendship bracelets.
No way.
Fuck yeah.
The fuck?
These are kind of cool.
Yeah, guys, by the way, G-Subs, fucking Gamer Subs.
Let's go.
Gamersubs.gg/Misfits.
Oh, no, it's code Misfits.
Let's fucking sick. Okay. Wait, holy shit.
I think they underestimated the size of my hand.
Yeah, my wrist is actually like at least 3 times bigger than this, mate. But
does it unclasp?
Yeah, that's how you put it on.
Elastomer.
Okay,
fucking hell, man.
I am not a jewelry man.
Okay, let's just all talk at once while we put these bracelets on.
Yo, lit.
Guys, what else has been happening? Let's move away from this because you know, the people on audio are probably going to start feeling left out pretty soon.
They should be watching the video.
We had an interesting night on Sunday. We did a practice
you did
show,
very exciting,
for potentially an up and coming tour. At some time this year, we really want to take the podcast and do a live tour and just make it a whole fucking show, make it a spectacle. And I don't know, we want to do a tour of the US, we want to do a tour of Australia. We got big plans. None of it's confirmed yet, but basically on Sunday we went to a local comedy bar, invited some friends along, and just did a live show to see how it would go. Because none of us, I mean, Jay, actually, you have stage experience.
Yeah.
I have like very little stage experience from
I have a little as well.
School and from when I did stand up in university, but it's been a while, you know, a bit rusty. So we kind of wanted to check that we wouldn't just die on stage and not know how to handle ourselves. But I think it went really well.
It was extremely well.
Yeah, all things considered.
Yeah. I mean, it wasn't in front of a real crowd, it was in front of our friends, but, you know. It sounded good. We were confident, I think. I think the show was pretty good. Needs refining, obviously, but I reckon we can actually make a pretty fucking entertaining hour and then do a Q&A and shit. And
it'll be epic.
It'll be epic style. Yeah. So yeah, hopefully at some point we will be taking this podcast on the road and just fucking selling the fuck
let's
out.
Just
honestly. Let's do it next week.
It's on a tour bus. Yeah. Imagine that. The content will be outstanding.
It would be.
And yeah, plus we'll be making big tour money.
Oh, that's the best part.
Yeah, so that's something potentially exciting. And yeah, after the practice show, we all proceeded to get completely fucked up.
We decided to go out to drink, and it was originally going to be, hey, just a couple of beers, you know, let's just relax, have a good night. And then, you know, someone's like, hey, skull a drink. And everyone's like, yeah, let's skull a drink. So we skull a couple beers and then immediately right pour more beers and then... Yeah. A
couple more.
Ryan just gets that look on his face and he just starts going get more shots and just feeds it to everyone.
It was Ryan really who was in charge, as always, of the level of fucked upness that everyone got. I actually kind of held my own a little bit because... I never had to skull a whole bottle of soju like Jay did and Swagger did. Yeah. I'm pretty sure Mason you skull as well.
Yeah.
Biggest regret of that night was skulling that fucking bottle of soju.
It's always the soju.
It's always the soju. So much. Like, that's so much alcohol.
It's only 12% though.
But that's like it was like 2 to 3 drinks. That's like 2 to 3 standard drinks.
It comes in like a beer too. So it's just I can just casually drink this.
Genuinely, oh, fuck. I've even forgotten what I was going to say now.
Jay's actually suffered permanent memory loss.
Permanent brain damage.
But I remember, Jay was the first one. I'm going to give up on putting this fucking bracelet on. It's too small. Thank you, though. Jay was the first one to skull it, and I knew as soon as I saw him.
Dude, he did fucking 10 seconds.
He did it so quick. I was actually impressed. I just knew it was going to be a remake of... Because you did the same thing in IEM Sydney. You just sculled the fuck out of
the soju there.
Soju there.
It's always soju. Big trash.
And you just lit the fuck up. He wasn't even like, Jay was good though. You're actually a really fun drunk.
Yeah.
I
feel like I'm just like the most lovable drunk.
When you're a drunk, Jay, you just let go of everything. And you're just lovable and you know, you're just like, I don't know.
Yeah.
It's good. It's good energy. It's always good to see.
Good vibes.
We're just having a staring contest for 30 seconds.
I'm pretty sure it was 30 minutes.
It went for a while. I was like, how long are we going to keep this up? And I am deadpan staring into his soul and he's just staring into mine.
Just not blinking.
Yeah.
That was the goal. It wasn't allowed to blink.
Yeah. And then, Mason got extremely
fucked.
He caught
up really quickly.
Yeah.
Yes.
I vomited 4 times that night.
I didn't vomit at all.
What's all this about? I must have been in the bathroom for this. But what happened between you and Cameron?
Don't say my full name like that.
That just makes it way more serious.
What happened?
No. I don't know. I was super drunk. I don't remember anything.
I don't think that any of us remember anything. We're just going to leave that
detail.
I'm going to leave that little
what
detail.
What the fuck? What is that?
Toby, you don't know?
I don't know.
Toby wasn't there.
Shit.
Why are you saying it like that?
Shit.
Toby wasn't there.
Let's just say that Toby missed out on a few little things.
Did I miss out on Mason's dreams?
On his what?
Mason's dreams coming true?
No.
You fucking wish, mate.
Look, we're going to leave out some details here because I just don't want to deal with the Twitter comments.
You do know that this just makes it sound way worse than I assume it was.
It probably does make it sound really bad.
Everyone's leave it to their imaginations. That's way more funny.
No one had sex. Basically, Mason just got so fucked up that
then
we ended
he
up...
finger bashed me in a bathroom.
That's true. I watched this.
It's pretty fucked up.
Definitely not from what happened. Far from the truth. We ended up carrying you through the streets of Melbourne, just shirtless, by your arms and legs, just screaming your head off.
Yeah. Yep.
And I feel like when you're in that state, part of it was you're playing it along with the bit, right?
Of course.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah.
But it was
At the same time, I can barely fucking move.
Yeah, so.
Dude, you were really
at that point.
You were trash, but you were also, you were fucking with us. But it was funny. We were literally carrying him arm and leg, and he was his hip was this close to the concrete, just almost hitting it every time.
I didn't even have to walk, mate.
It's also raining and shit.
Yeah.
And you just had so much energy. You just kept on towards the end of the night, you literally were chasing me through the streets. And I was just trying to escape because you were trying to jump onto me and hang onto me like a koala.
Yeah, and I just kept clawing on you. I was fucking...
I was just look, I don't have the energy for this anymore. So I was running along. I managed to escape you. And then, you eventually caught up and you just fucking literally bolted into me and just... clasped onto me like a koala, and then I was like, "All right, I think you need to go home."
We're done.
But before that, we were carrying Mason.
Mm.
We were walking to Burger King,
Hungry Jack's,
as it's called in Australia.
Yeah,
we see these police officers just standing around looking real suspect, and they were looking at us as well. And I was like, "Oh man, I hope they don't fucking start asking us questions or some shit," because Mason literally looked like he was on crack cocaine. Yeah. Just
it was scary. Yeah,
it was an exorcism kind of shit.
Scuffed, bald cunt walking down, just all.
Yeah, and we were just carrying him, and it turns out that they were actually standing around this homeless guy who appeared to be bleeding, unfortunately.
Wait, God, that really?
I don't know. I think there was something wrong with this homeless guy. You know, God bless him. Hope he's okay.
I was literally the whole night, I was looking at homeless people and I was just telling everyone, I was like, is he homeless? Like, what's, is he okay? Is he okay? To everyone.
You're like a kid at the zoo, Jay.
That was what I felt like. Wait, one of them was bleeding?
There was a guy lying down. I don't know if he was bleeding or not. You know, like.
I might have actually seen something that I shouldn't have.
Needless to say, this homeless guy was not in a good way, and these cops were, I think, just trying to... They were waiting for paramedics or something, or I don't know what they were doing, but they were basically guarding this homeless guy. We just walk past Carrie and Mason, arm and leg.
and they were like, no, we got fucking priorities.
Yeah,
we
were like,
fuck this shit.
Evening, and just walked on past the Burger King. And then we just proceeded to... I mean, I was actually significantly less drunk than everyone else, so I was just kind of enjoying the show. Jay was... off his tits.
Are we at Hungry Jack's yet?
Yeah, Hungry Jack's.
Oh, fuck.
We're at Hungry Jack's, and Ryan places a big order as usual.
Oh my God. I was screaming for chips. I was like, where's the chippies? Where's the chippies? And then a bag just appears in front of me. I was screaming for like 20 minutes. It just boom. And I look in the bag and there's just hundreds upon hundreds of chips. Oh. And I freak out.
And they were fucking fresh.
They were
too.
So good.
From then,
it was so good.
From then on, Jay was just in pure ecstasy eating these Hungry Jack's chippies.
Holy shit.
He was also, we also had like McDonald's sauce from next door.
Yeah, there's a McDonald's right next door to it too.
And yeah, and then Mason got into the fucking burgers, the Whoppers.
Yeah.
I don't know if you remember this. I actually have a lot of footage on my phone of you just sitting there holding like a floppy burger, shaking it around your hand and going, this is the best burger ever. Hungry Jack's makes the best burgers.
The burgers are better at Hungry Jack's.
I do remember being in that loop of the burgers are better at Hungry Jack's.
For like 20 minutes. Yeah. We were just
Hungry Jack's makes the best burgers. Yeah. McDonald's is shit. You guys are way better.
I had to be separated. I remember having to be separated from Mason because I started throwing shit at him, being like, say something else. Yeah. Say something else. You're being unoriginal. And I was throwing shit, spitting water at him. Like, he threw a chip at my eye.
It was crazy.
Wasn't our editor Mitchell sitting next to you and he was feeding you chips?
Yeah, and they were the best chips. And I found out later that he was picking them up off the floor and feeding them. They were so good. Are you kidding me? What kind of seasonings on the floor?
Extra grease.
Oh my God.
Mason saying that this was the best burger ever. Last night I went out because they were streaming. So I drove at like 4 a.m. and I got Mason and Kobe some Whoppers.
And they were the shittest burgers.
And they were so crap.
But what do you expect? It's 4 a.m.
Yeah.
You're just going to get Burger King foot lettuce
in
that hour.
No, but in theory, you would think that at 4 a.m., because no one else is ordering at that time, they would have to make something fresh for you.
No, but the workers are like, they're tired.
Yeah,
4 a.m. is at a fast food joint is like, fuck anyone who comes in here because they're normally drunk and they're just sick of your shit.
Yeah.
And yes, this group was very drunk and they were very sick of our shit. There were people right on the booth next to us. Like, just enjoying a meal, just having a conversation.
Are you kidding me?
And Mason's just in the back like, Hungry Jack's makes the best fucking burgers, cat. Like, just over and over. I've never seen you get stuck in a loop.
I saw throwing fucking chips everywhere and shit,
dude. Fucking, this one hit me in the eye and I had permanent eye damage.
Just like, never recovered.
Never. It was fucked.
But yeah, I mean, that's basically what happened on Sunday. Good celebration for the test tour.
Yeah. Because it was fucking good and it's going
to
be great.
It was great. I was a little worried as to how it was going to go. But after that, I feel very confident that we can pull off a good tour.
So good.
So what we did was we basically contacted this comedy club, a really nice comedy club in Melbourne. Mm. And they said that we could do a test thing there. And we kind of just sat on a stage with, there was probably like 10 friends in the crowd.
Yeah.
And we just sat on some stools and did a full podcast as if it was the live show, you know, not breaking it and anything, just completely committing to it, and it worked really well.
Yeah, I was able to wear my helmet for 32 minutes straight,
which
until it started to hurt,
and
then I had to take it off and continue the show. It was funny, every time I had the microphone in my hand, because it's not like we had stands, we were holding them, and I tried to put it up to my mouth, and it just fucking clang on my helmet, just make this fucking noise.
Yeah, but
you gotta be more mindful.
I shook the owner's hand and he nearly fucking broke it.
What happened there?
Oh, he just like came up and he was like, oh, yeah, g'day, mate. Nice to meet you. I was like, yeah, nice to meet you, mate. And he shook my hand. I'm like, oh, what the fuck, man?
You actually said that.
Yeah. He did.
No, yeah. I think I literally said, like, oh, you fucking cunt or something.
Yeah, actually?
Yeah, he was like, whoa, what, are you okay? Are you okay?
I'm like, nah, I'm all right, mate.
is that because you hurt your hand?
Yeah. Yeah, no, I sprained it. So like,
but he didn't tell the guy that. He was just like, oh, you, nah, just, you hurt my hand.
I just wasn't expecting like such a firm fucking grip.
No, no, what I mean was, so you got your hand shook and then you just kind of freaked out and you just kept freaking out. But you never at any point told him,
oh,
it's because my hand was already sore. Like, you just left him thinking that you're a weak little bitch who couldn't handle a handshake.
I did inform him, okay? All right.
Yeah, a while after
you. He no longer thinks I'm a weak little bitch, all right?
Go up to him like 30 minutes later. Hey, mate, just so you know, I'm not actually a bitch. I just sprained my hand.
I'm actually a tough dog, man. Come on.
It was funny. We had this whole comedy club to ourselves. It's weird as well because like lots of comedy legends had been on that stage before us. Like up on the screen, we're seeing Rogan, Kevin Hart, you know, a lot of big
Jimmy
names.
Jimmy Carr.
And here we are, just this most scuffed group with like very little experience. We ate a whole fish and chips meal.
With no fish.
With no fish. Like before the show, like the place was just, it was such a weird experience. I'm really glad that they were so welcoming to us.
Yeah.
So shout out to them, even though I've literally forgotten the name of the club.
So bye.
Fucking rip. No, it was
announced soon.
It was good. And yeah, I mean, it was really just evidence that we could actually pull the shit off.
Yeah.
We apparently are talented.
Apparently.
In theory.
We just need to kind of come up with, I guess, antics to make the show interesting. And,
to make it the best.
That's like, more than just the podcast,
You know.
But needless to say, after the show, we were all as energized as fuck.
Oh, yeah.
There's nothing really... I've forgotten what it feels like to actually perform like that. Mm. And, you know, obviously we're only doing it in front of our close friends, so there was no risk. But it's still like, you feel good performing. Like, it's like, oh, shit, this is like actually...
It was a quick hour.
It was a quick hour.
It went by very, very quick.
Very easy, very relaxed. Yeah, and obviously it's just the podcast that we were doing, really. But it's still, you know... Sometimes it's hard. Podcasting is actually like a lot harder than I thought it would be.
It's extremely hard to do live.
Yeah.
But just in general, even like this podcast, I think has taught me a lot about like, or just given me a new respect for really fucking good podcasts and just how they can just keep going for hours. Cause, I don't know, man, like it's different than I thought it would be. It's like, when I went into this, I was like, oh, surely it'll be fucking easy. Like we've got so many stories, keep it going for an hour. But it's actually like, you know, at times it's like, man, this is actually, takes a lot of mental effort to do the show. Not that I'm complaining. I'm just
got to talk more shit, dude.
Yeah, you've got some shit to talk about.
Speaking of shit, Jay, how was your Uber ride over here?
Oh my god, it was the worst Uber ride. Okay, so like, I'm coming from a house, and the first thing I see was like this. It's watch this guy's video about how like awesome of an Uber driver he is, and I'm like, oh shit. I watch it. I'm like, yeah, this is sick as.
Oh, like on the actual app.
Yeah. On
the
app.
What is that?
It's like a dating profile shit. It's like tell their whole life story.
It was like he's completed 7,000 5-star trips. And I'm like, oh shit, I got the best one ever. I walk. I go into the Uber. I'm like, has this guy like been farting and shit in here? Because it smelled like it like reeked of farts.
Oh my god!
And so I was like, I can deal with it. It's only like a 5-minute drive here. And turns out there's massive traffic. It was like 20-25 minutes to get here when it's supposed to be like 5 minutes. And I'm 90% sure that the Uber driver shit himself because he leans over to like the right and does that awkward pose where you're like, oh fuck, I got a sore ass stomach and I need to let out a fart. But if I like sit up straight, it'll just be the loudest fart ever.
Oh, no.
And so he lets out the silent and the most violent fart. And like, as soon as he does it, I just see all the windows just go. And I'm like, okay. And then it just fucking reeked.
Oh, man, I bet he would have been embarrassed. Like, you got
it. Like, I obviously had a bit of sympathy for him, but then he's driving at like 200 k's an hour trying to get to his destination so I can get out of the car. Bro, I was like, my god.
Dude, fucking, yeah, I mean... As the Uber driver, as soon as you roll down the windows after that, you're basically just admitted defeat. You're basically just told your passenger, like, yeah, that was me, dude.
Yeah.
My bad.
Like, he 100% knew that he shit himself, but like, like, can I sue him? I'm literally going to get pink eye. Like,
can I sue him?
Can I sue him?
I don't think that's going to hold up in court.
He farted on me.
He farted. He like basically hotboxed you.
Yeah, holy shit. That was a 0.2 star experience.
And it was raining.
Did
like
you
hell.
Rate him?
No. Should I?
Look, dude, I'm not the kind of guy to ever leave a review below five stars.
I don't if I'm not going.
Because, you know, it's a tough gig being an Uber driver.
Exactly. Especially if you actually have, like, some problem down there.
Yeah, you know, if he's sick, you know, you don't know if he just fucking went to Hungry Jack's and had a bad Whopper and then all of a sudden, you know, oh, shit, you know, oh, this just came up.
Yeah.
And, you know, like I already accepted the ride, you know, so, you know, he just had an unfortunate evening.
Yeah, so I had a bit of sympathy for him, but at the end of the day, like, if I get pink eye, he's...
You're going to sue him.
Swagger,
sue
him, yeah. I reckon that you, considering that your face isn't public, you should be an Uber driver for a week, see how it goes.
I honestly think you should do that.
Fuck driving people around, especially people I don't know in my own, you know, if you don't even have a car to drive people in either.
It is funny how common it's become, like, because, you know, Uber is obviously very safe, but it's, it's kind of crazy how it's now just the norm to get in a stranger's car. Like, oh yeah, I'll just get an Uber.
Like, is that like what the joke is? Like, your parents always told you not to like get in strangers' cars from people you met on the internet, and then you do just
but,
that.
But you know, there's a database, and you know, you could report Uber drivers if they do something wrong. Yeah. It's very easily like, tracked and,
Uber
and all of that shit.
It's unbelievably unsafe.
I mean, all it
to
takes
some
is,
degree.
All it takes
there's
is them
so
to just
many
a bad...
Uber murders and Uber rapes and all that.
Really?
That's a zero star.
I don't know. Yeah, that's a one star rating.
I wouldn't know if there's very many. Like, really, like two or three a year is a lot. You know, like
I mean,
there's always
earlier
be
on there was a lot more as well, I guess. But in the early days of Uber, it was fucked. Yeah. There was news articles like every week about it.
That's fucked.
Yeah, I don't know how much of that is media hype and how much of it's an actual problem. I've gotten into hundreds of Ubers and I've never had an issue. But then again, I'm not a woman.
It might be a case of like, you know, the kind of bullshit that Tesla has to deal with on Twitter, where you know, news articles are constantly like, Tesla has an accident where like this happened and passenger gets damaged. And it's like, but like their stats are like 70% lower than every other car.
It's like when you're like the new up and coming thing that's like different from everyone else. Everyone targets you and looks for that shit wrong, you know?
Whereas he's like, writing hit pieces on
Uber. But I mean, even if it is like 0.1%, that doesn't mean that it's not a problem, you know?
It's a problem, but it's also like you take a risk every day when you just go out in public.
No, you know? I'm not like I still use Ubers all the time.
Yeah, but the point is that like you can't at a certain level, a certain percentage, you can't judge the company because you just that's just the risk of being a person. No, in society.
The company policy isn't if you get in our. If you get in our car, we're going to rape and murder you.
The company policy is hire anyone that has a heartbeat without checking anything.
Sure. Uber definitely has its issues. And apparently they're getting worse as you know, as far as how they treat their drivers. So I don't know, dude.
That's why they're shitting on people now. Yeah.
But I mean, it's also a godsend. I mean, like it
so
shows
convenient.
Very few young people are getting even driver's licenses anymore because Uber is just so fucking convenient. Like, why would you even bother? It's pretty safe, you know? And you don't have to worry about driving drunk and shit or high.
I've had some interesting, you know, discussions with Uber drivers, you know, like over the, you know, over like the last couple of months that I've been here. Like I've had some really interesting talks with people that have interesting backgrounds. This one guy, he was like, he was majoring in astrophysics and then he dropped down and he did like computer science and programming for like, he got like a doctorate in it. And then he just ended up like retiring and he just drives Ubers. So, you know, I was just talking with him. I was like, yeah, what do you think of all this like AI shit? Like, what do you think of, you know, all that? I was having like that conversation and he was telling me, he's like, oh, dude, like, this is like what I study. Like, this is what I'm really into. And, you know, we're having a conversation about AI and he's, you know, we're just fucking, I'm driving to Ryan's house. And he's just, you know, driving me there. It's a 15-minute drive. And he's like, yeah, you know, at a certain point, you know, the rate of technology as we go up with artificial intelligence, it's an exponential curve. And you know how in an exponential curve, when it gets, when it approaches like the peak part where it just goes from nothing to just infinite, he says, as soon as you hit that, it's going to be an instantaneous, irreversible change because we're going to go from knowing nothing to knowing everything in an instant. And the way he's describing this to me was just absolutely scary and mind-boggling. He's like, hey, man, buckle up because this is happening in your lifetime. Maybe not mine, but definitely yours.
It's crazy. I mean, AI, it's going to be very similar to the boom of the internet, I guess, which is, you could say, definitely followed a similar curvature. Like at the beginning, only a very few people used it, and all of a sudden, it's like everyone uses it all the fucking time and everything is on it and you can't live your life without it.
I wouldn't mind like fucking AI robots and shit.
Bro, it's kind of creepy though.
Yeah,
right?
But that's you, Mason.
But, yeah,
you just want to fuck something.
Like, what?
You just want to fuck a robot.
I can get a bit crafty. I can make my own, mate.
What kind of robots are you looking into, mate?
Ones with big lips.
Big old lips.
Have you seen that thing that came out that Joe Rogan recently tweeted and talked about where they took his voice and made it sound like he was having like these conversations about like that he invested in an ice hockey team completely comprised of chimps and, you know, like what it's like being a robot. And it sounded, if you had heard it, You would not have suspected
that. That's the shit that scares me.
Yeah, you would not have suspected that it was like a deepfake. And very recently, I think it was Samsung's AI team demonstrated an AI that was able to show a person talking and moving their head and doing everything from one picture, from one angle.
That's unreal.
That's like they were taking like old classic paintings and like making them talk
making
and like move their heads around.
Lisa talk like.
Yeah, literally. That's, they were doing shit like that.
That is very, very, very dangerous.
Yeah.
It is extremely dangerous.
I mean, deepfakes just in general are crazy good.
That's fucked.
Yeah. And like
it's
really
very much going to be like it's going to reach that age on the internet where you literally just cannot see or believe anything you see.
It's going to get there. It's already almost there. There was, I can't remember who the actor was. It's a famous actor. He wasn't
Jordan Peele. I think.
No, it was something else. It was on a talk show. Okay. I can't remember what it was. And like someone phased another person's face completely onto it. And like it was the creepiest thing because it was literally phasing in and out of the other person's face into his regular face in real time. And it was so seamless that you could barely even tell like which face that he had. It was like this weird blend of the two.
Right.
And it was like you're like, what am I looking at? This is so distressing. Like,
some weird like, cunt's going to like fucking program a robot to purge cunts or some shit.
Bro, some crazy shit is coming in our lifetime.
Yeah. You say something like that. I believe it was DARPA that was working on a robot that it was programmed for war and it ran off of biomass, like biofuel. So what it would do, essentially, the design of this robot was it would murder people on the battlefield and then it would eat their body for fuel.
Are you kidding me?
Literally like
that
Terminator
was,
shit.
I believe
what
that was that was the design. I could be wrong.
When was this? Like what time?
It was a couple. It was a while ago.
Six months ago. That's what like apparently they were looking into. I don't know if they canceled the project.
No, they made it, but then they eventually canceled it because everyone was like, what the fuck?
Well, you know, you're going to make a fucking robot that eats people? Are you fucking insane?
You know how many movies are at that? We already know what's going to happen.
They'll literally start digging through graveyards and shit to fucking get fuel.
What about a nuclear reactor, Dio? You can't just put a fucking nuclear reactor on it and be like, that's fine, that's good enough for energy, or solar power?
Nah.
And it has to eat bodies?
It's going
to
solve a lot of problems. It's going to like break into old people's homes and eat the people.
Yeah, true.
Just get rid of them. That's what I say.
It'll solve the like population issue.
We're already overpopulated. Just start killing cunts and eating them. Like, get the robots to take care of
them. Just rename it to Thanos and you're good.
Just let them loose.
Thanos won.
That's terrifying. It actually consumes human flesh.
Yes.
And then just makes it into biomatter or something.
Something like that.
Biofuel.
It just fucking runs on it.
Fuck, imagine how scary it would be just seeing a robot munching on a human.
Yeah, I wonder what his mouth looks like.
Would it, of water and
would
toss
it be
out.
Like would it be like one of those wood chippers where it's just like you just suck
it? I don't wanna know. That's too much detail.
It's the high tech blender.
Guys, welcome back to Blend Tech. Today on World Blend.
Oh,
fucking
no.
Jesus
don't
Christ.
Like that.
Will
like
it blend? Hey. Grandma. Hey.
If you're ever in a situation, you're running away from a flesh-eating robot, you're like, shit, I just don't have enough energy, go to gamersups.gg/misfits. Or use code misfits.
Whatever. We always just, fuck up the URL.
Yeah, just fucking, it's gamersups.gg. Go there, fucking misfits. It's the best fucking drink. You'll get energy. It's keto. It's vegan. It's lent.
Yeah.
All right?
And it ain't chalky like G Fuel. Fuck him.
Yeah. Make you run fast.
G Fuel isn't for gamers.
No, it's not. No. It's really not for gamers.
It's too mainstream.
You know what G Fuel's for? Normies.
Gays.
Yeah.
Gay fuel. Oh, shit. That's a... Whoa, that's
right,
too far.
We're now awaiting a lawsuit.
Gay fuel.
Allegedly.
I often had a conversation with my parents, actually, where I was telling them that there wouldn't be something in my lifetime as dramatic as the internet was in their lifetime in terms of, like, a change that just flips society, like, head over heels.
Yeah.
But it seems like AI really will be that for us.
Oh,
yeah. I think so. Extremely. I mean,
AI will be crazy.
AI isn't all a bad thing. Bad stuff comes with AI, but a lot of really great stuff comes with it too. I mean, they've been working on, I believe, making fusion reactors for ages. And one of the issues with making a fusion reactor is that you can have the reactor, but in order to have the fusion reaction go for a while, they have to have the perfect like write, you know, all, they have thousands of variables they have to tweak and adjust every time they do an experiment, and then they compare, and it's just a lot of fucking manual labor of them trying to mix and match variables to get the right result. Now, with AI and machine learning, it can just fucking calculate everything, yeah. And, you know, you just do, you know, simulations and you just get the exact right results and the perfect outcome that they need.
Yeah, you know, fucking smart.
I feel like the real danger with AI isn't, you know, the typical fear of a post-apocalypse where the AI takes over and starts murdering people in the streets.
Singularity.
It's more, the danger with it is more how many people are going to be out of work because their position will just become irrelevant, and how much is it going to affect just how convenient it makes everyone's life? Because I feel like that's dangerous to a certain extent. Like, we kind of, society is just becoming more and more convenient. Yeah. More and more things are just being removed as far as like effort you actually have to put in. Mm. And I think that's a big reason why we might be seeing a big rise in things like depression and anxiety, is because
people just have nothing to do.
People, they just like all of the responsibilities that normally you kind of need to have in order to feel fulfilled. Yeah. Like, you don't need them anymore. Like, you can, like, there's a lot of things that just are that are kind of essential. Like, even exercise or leaving the house.
It's gonna be like Wall-E. You're just sitting on a chair at the end of the day, you know.
It's an interesting statistic that people in first world countries compared to third world countries have exponentially higher rates of suicide. That more people in a first world country, you know, with running water, with access to food, you know, access to tons of resources, you know, are, you know, get to the point where they off themselves. Whereas somebody in a third world country, you'd think, well, their life must be so miserable. You know, they have to go and get water every day, and, you know, the water's not always clean, and, you know, they have to fend off against, you know, you know, fucking predators, and, you know, having to make sure that their community is okay, or, you know, they're ridden with war and anything like that.
Which all of those things are true, obviously. Yes. But yeah, like, it's definitely, like,
them a reason to survive.
As far as how you feel day to day, I think there's a big difference there.
I feel like first world countries as well, you're a lot more exposed to better things, like something that's better than you have. Like, you're a lot more exposed to, like, hope and, like, your dreams and stuff of what you could have. And often that is very unobtainable.
I mean, happiness is very perspective based. And like, if you're surrounded constantly with people who seem better than you, you're always going to feel like shit. You know,
I don't feel that bad.
Yeah, but, you know, it's, I don't know. Look, the last thing we're trying to say here is that people in third world countries have it easy.
No, that was not my point.
That's not the point. I just feel like I have to say it because I know there'll be some idiot in the comments like, look at these fucking first world assholes complaining about their problem. Like,
Look, not at all.
I'm just saying that it's interesting how, like, convenience isn't necessarily always a beneficial thing in the long term for society. And, like, I feel like a lot of people in society as it is now actually have to go back to more rudimentary forms of living their life to kind of get a just kind of feel like they're in place in some sense and feel like they're okay. Like, that's why people go out of their way to exercise when they don't have to anymore. It's because, like, it's actually important that you otherwise you will literally just feel kind of like incompetent, I guess, in some way.
Everybody should own a farm.
That's
you know, you wake up at 6 a.m., you feed the chickens, you milk the cows, you do your work, you plow the fields.
You fuck your sister.
It's perfect. It's paradise.
Putting in rewarding work is just fucking super important. And I'm just worried that AI is going to just remove more and more of that, to the point where it's just like, you're just getting spoon-fed everything that you need. But you're not really getting everything that you need, like, in terms of mental stimulation.
Like, not what you really need.
AI YouTubers are going to be lit.
It's just gonna be like Bill Clinton and stuff.
It's gonna be like there's gonna be this, like, social media celebrities that are literally just androids, just that are designed to be perfect in every single way.
If they just start making, like, a fake celebrity on, like, something like Twitter, where it's like they don't exist, they come up with someone's face again, like someone that doesn't exist, and it just has an AI to do tweet and everything, you know?
Yeah, imagine if they can make a fake Instagram model, like you're saying, and just totally generate an image of a person that doesn't exist, but they've just got that is perfect.
AI knows, like, what kind of post does well, and it just keeps doing it.
Hatsune Miku, that virtual anime girl that does the concerts and stuff, she's kind of like a virtual celebrity.
Yeah.
But, you know, not in the sense that she's an AI or anything, but, you know.
But that's also, like, you know, it's open that's obviously an AI.
Obviously.
What we're talking about is, like, imagine like they just create an Instagram model from scratch,
right?
And just
that looks real.
That looks real. Everything about them is real, yeah. And they just
blows up.
They just generate posts every day that are just fucking amazing, incredible. Like, oh my god, this person.
And they're
an
actually
amazing
taking
life.
Videos, and it's deep fake.
Yeah.
Everything's
like everything's 100% AI generated.
That would be an incredible demonstration.
That could easily happen within 5 years.
And then companies just farm brand deals, and they just make millions off these fake
influencers. Holy shit, let's cut this out. Are you kidding me? We're gonna make millions.
Maybe they already exist right now.
What if we're off?
Black Mirror, guys. We're living in Black Mirror.
New Black Mirror is coming out soon, actually.
I mean, I'm so excited.
Instagram people's lives are fake enough as it is anyway.
You're not gonna notice any difference. Who cares?
Yeah.
Instagram is it's very crazy. Fucked. Instagram is so fucked. I don't go on the app anymore. I should probably post on it more.
I deactivated mine.
I don't follow people. I follow like car stuff and shit like that. But people, it's just so strange.
Yeah, I feel like it's bad to like just label it as like, oh, Instagram's bad. Like you can still follow stuff like your hobbies and your own interests, you know. But like you can get too deep into it, just following like celebrities and shit.
It's just weird to think that a lot of people every day will think, oh, time to take out my rectangle and scroll through people whose lives are better than mine for like 30 minutes. Like that's an active decision that lots of people make every single day.
And
like,
it's
just weird.
There's also the other side of it where there's so many like young people that, you know, they'll have like 500 followers or something and they'll treat it like a job. You know? It's like, oh, I gotta get a photo out today. Oh, I didn't get that many likes today. And it's like all of their self-worth comes from followers and likes and shit.
Aspiring influencers. That's a touchy one.
Yeah.
Especially when they already feel entitled when they only have like a couple thousand followers.
Yeah. There was someone that DM'd me on Instagram today saying, like, I've got so many followers and bragging. It was literally just an account of your video clips that had 55k followers. That was just the biggest ego I've ever
seen. Shit cunts, man.
Like,
I don't know. It's very weird. Remember that kid that was locked outside VidCon the other year?
Wait, what happened? That fucking model guy yelling at the security guard, going like you're nobody. Waste of life. You know any of that shit.
Yeah, there's just this kid, this attractive young guy, and he clearly had an Instagram page. I think he had like 10,000 followers.
13K.
This kid was just off his nut ego wise. Yeah. Just like, I'm a fucking influencer. You're fucking like disgusting. You're ugly. Whatever.
Yeah. Like the internet, like finally blow up and like blow up the security guard. Now he has more followers than the first guy.
The security guard made an Instagram and then got him more followers.
It's just like crazy to think there's a lot of kids out there like that guy
that
don't blow up. Like that don't like, no one knows that they're being assholes every day. Like there's a lot of people that just live with that mentality of like, my fucking little, I'm an influencer. I get my fucking
clout, by the way.
Mm. Oh, dude, it's gross, dude.
Clout is gay.
I hate that term, clout is so dumb.
I don't like that word.
It's such an LA word.
Yes.
Fucking hate it.
I've got something. I got a story to tell.
Let's go. It's not a big story.
It's a very short story. Okay. But someone came into my chat the other day and they go, my Twitch chat, and they're like, hey, Toby, are you aware that your sister is selling spoons for $10? I was like, what the fuck? She's selling spoons for $10?
Like
turns out
the utensil?
The utensil.
Okay, I was going to say, I was like,
no. But turns out my little sister was taking spoons to her school and selling them as Misfits used spoons.
Oh my god.
Isn't that hilarious?
That is, and probably, you know, that shit would have been at the dishwasher.
She's a fucking shithead cunt.
I mean, also, like, you guys went to my house once.
Were people buying them?
Are you saying
your sister, when she came here, actually stole spoons from the Misfits house?
No. From my house in New Zealand.
So she's just lying.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm more pissed off about that than I am that she's selling our spoons.
There's maybe a chance you would have used one, and there's a chance I would have used one.
I may have used one as well.
That's in the fine print. Like, 1% chance Fitz licked the spoon at some point.
Dude, people
are buying this shit?
It's like spoon fart value.
Here's the thing.
She's made millions.
Here's the thing. Like, my little sister, you know, she's got parents that will buy her, like, she gets spoiled like a little shit. Why does she need $10? Why is she selling
$10 bucks a fucking spoon, cunt? She probably selling like 10 at a time.
I just don't understand why. Has people bought it? People have bought these spoons?
Well, the person came to our chat and said, hey, my mate bought a spoon off your sister for 10 bucks.
That must be a weird fucking thing.
And my reaction was instantly like, why did she only charge 10 bucks? Like, she doesn't need that money. Why is she doing it?
Bro, that's odd. That's weird. How would they have even known that it was a Misfits used spoon and just not a spoon that she just took out? Because it's probably just a spoon that she took out of the drawer. Yeah,
no, I mean, also, when I lived at home, it was the same as living here. I ordered Uber Eats pretty much every day.
I didn't even use your spoons.
I actually just use plastic spoons. They're not actual metal ones.
I didn't even ever use plates. Like, there's very few things in my house that I would have actually used. She should be selling cups.
Wait, can we
see this little brand branding opportunity?
She's in the wrong game.
Does that mean that we can start like listing all our trash and Uber Eats bags on eBay?
Oh my god,
like $5 a pop. People will buy it. There we go.
Don't even start, dude. What the fuck?
Where is this conversation going?
That's weird, man. It's just so weird.
Clout.
It's like
funny that someone bought one. I mean, it doesn't surprise me either, though.
It's funny that she had the idea in the first place. Who's like, was there like demand for it? Yeah. People like, yo, you know what you should do? You should fucking sell some spoons because I would totally buy one.
My little sister, she, I feel like she probably tells people.
How old is she again?
14, 15?
Too young to be selling spoons.
Too young to be selling meth.
Yeah, that's what they're using them for. She's just selling them to crack addicts.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was a good spoon.
You look like you need a spoon, bitch.
Heroin spoons.
Yeah,
oh my god.
No, it's so crazy. I mean,
it's nuts.
Like, my little having a family member who is the same age as sort of our audience, like my two sisters, one's 17, one's 14 or 15. So they both are at high school, and high school is like our primary demographic. So having a sibling that lives in the same house as me, that has friends that, you know, watch me and stuff, was so weird. Because, you know, she'd bring friends over and there'd be people that would just knock on my door and I'd be like, what the fuck is going on? And just kids would come in and be like, hi, can I get a picture? It's like,
oh my god.
Really uncomfortable.
It would be uncomfortable.
Because, you know, purely because it was in my own house where it's like the privacy.
People probably ask her when she's at school as well, like about us. I know my brother has to go through some of that, who's still in high school. It's just weird, man. It's a weird dynamic for sure.
It's weird for some of my friends that are still in college. And this one girl I know, she said that she went out with this guy and, you know, they went back to his and, you know, they did whatever. And then they were lying in bed and the guy turns to her and goes, hey, do you watch any YouTubers? And she's like, yeah, you know, I watch a couple or whatever. And he goes, yeah, I've been watching this one guy for a while. I don't know if you heard of him. And, you know, his name's a bit like, yeah, it's kind of weird. You probably haven't heard of him. And she's like, well, who is it? Whatever. And he goes, it's Swagger Souls. He's like, I know the name is weird. And he does like gaming stuff.
That
so maybe you didn't
like,
know.
That sounds like someone that is trying to figure out who you are.
Do you have a picture of his face?
Yeah, it's like, you know who he
no,
is.
No. Because he didn't know that she knew me. Or any of that shit. But
are you sure?
It seems weird that he would bring that up unless he knew.
The line of questioning
seems like he was trying to hide it.
I don't know her that well. She just brought this up to me. She said it was just a random thing that she just brought it up because he apparently was a fan and he was just watching my videos all the time.
So did she tell him that?
No, she didn't tell him anything, but she told me that and she said she thought it was funny. It's just weird. It's just really weird, I guess widespread we are, where like my friends that know me, that know to keep like, you know, my identity a secret, just, you know, have it brought up to them, or like they see me on Instagram or anything and they're always like, dude, like, you know, I overhear people talking about your videos like in class.
We are so fucking famous. Holy shit.
My dad, my dad is a doctor. And one time my dad was seeing a patient and the patient's son was in the room with him watching one of our videos on his phone.
Oh my god, really?
Isn't that crazy?
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Dude, that's so odd.
Thanks for the ad riff. Awesome.
Beauty.
How fucking deep are we into this thing? Is anyone timing this shit?
We're about an hour.
About an hour?
Yeah.
Let's wrap this shit up.
Yeah.
Has anyone got anything else they wanted to bring up?
Thanks to Game of Subs. Make sure to go to the Patreon as well.
Patreon.
Yes, guys, Patreon.
Pledge to the Patreon if you want to support us.
If you want extra shit.
So
and,
good.
And
so
if you want us to just be making podcast content because honestly, we can't really afford to keep going on the budget that we're setting for ourselves.
Yeah.
And it'd be really nice to just have a monthly set budget where it's like, oh, we have this much to just fucking spend on making an insane video.
Yeah.
So, But yeah, patreon.com/misfits, G-subs, code misfits. And yeah, we'll see you guys next week.
Yeah.
Peace.
Thanks. Bye, buddy.
Later.
Let 'em, motherfuckers.